Hello everyone, we're glad to introduce our video crash course for IBPS PO Clerk Prelim 2018. Before starting the video, I'd like to give a short intro about our video classes. Our video crash course contains 100 plus hours of videos covering complete syllabus of IBPS PO Clerk Prelim syllabus, and also you can view these videos in both the language English as well as Hindi, and also you can learn the concept from our skilled expert at the comfort of your place, and also you can revise as many as time you want. Also, video course include latest pattern question, and at the end of the video class, you can practice a question as a mock test. Professional mentor will be available for guiding you on daily basis, and also there is a doubt clearing session so that you can clear your all doubts regarding any concept. For more details, visit ibpsguide.com and link is in the description box. Hello everyone, welcome to IBPS Guide. So in this particular video, we will see a one cumulative type data interpretation, which is very important for your IBPS PO Clerk Pre 2018. So without further delay, let's move toward our data interpretation. First question. Question is, table given below shows the total number of employee in percentage out of total employee working in given company. Study the data carefully and answer the following question. Okay, out of total employee, percentage of employee in a given company is given according to their ages. So 30 and above their ages, in company A 50%, in company B 70%, in company C 60%, 40% and above peoples are 40% in company A, B, in 30% in company C 40%, and 50% and above in age, in company A 20, in company B 20, in company C 30. So total number of employee in company A is 1200, total number of employee in company B is 800, and total number of employee in C will be 900. So total number of employee, question 1 is, total number of employee whose age is 30 and above in company C. So total number of employee in company C is 900. 30 and above in company C will be 60%. So 60% of 900 C. 10% of 900 is 90, then 60% will be 540, clear? 540 is what percent more than the total number of employee whose age is 40 and above in company A? 40 and above in company A, that is 40%, and total number of employee in company A will be 1200. So 40% of 1200, 10% is 120, then 40% will be 480. How much more it is? It is 60 more. But base mein kya lenge? Then ke baad wala, that is total number of employee whose age is 40 and above, that is 480 into 100. Hana, cut. Ye jayega 2, 2 ja 4, 2, 4 ja 8. Ye chala jayega 5 times, 2, 5 ja 10. Ye jayega aapka kitna? 6, 4 ja 24, 6, 10 ja 60. 2 2 is 4, 2 5 is 10, 5 5 is 25. So 25 by 2, which will give 12.5%. So option number 4 will be the correct answer. Now next question. Question 2. Total number of person in company B whose age is 30 and above but less than 40 is how much more than the number of person in company A whose age is 40 and above but less than 50. Now consider company B. See, this is the line. These are the person whose age is 30, and these are the person whose age are 40. So 30 and above means these people, 40 and less than means this persons, hana. So for 30 and above in company B is 70, 40 and above 30%. So 70% for 30%, take the difference between them, that is 70 minus 30, that is 40%. So to find out these persons, just take a 40% of company B, total number of employee is 800, that is 10% is 80, then 40% is 8 for 32, 320. Clear to everyone or not? Clear. Now same concept should be applied in other part of this same question. The total number of employee company A whose age is 40 and above but less than 50. So 40 and above in company A, 40. 50 and above, take that difference, 40 minus 20, that is 20%. So company A is total employee is 1200. So 20% of 1200, that will gives you 240. that 20% of 1200, which gives you 240. So how much more? Yes, exactly, 80 more. So option number 2 will be the correct answer. Clear or not? Next question. Question 3. Find the ratio between the total number of employee in company C whose age is 30 and above but less than 50. Same concept which I have applied in second question. Okay. To the total number of employee in company A whose age is 30 and above but less than 50. Now in company C, first we talk about company C, whose age is 30 and above, that is 60%, but less than 50 means 30%. So 60 minus 30, that is 30% of total number of employee in company C will be 900. Clear? Divided by ratio lena hai to the number of employee in company A whose age is 30 and above but less than 50, means 30 and above in company A 50, 50 and above matlab 50 and less than means 20. So 50 minus 20 is 30%. So 30% of total number of employee, that is 1200. So see, 30% of 1200, 30% cut down, off cut down, 2020, this ratio will give 3:4, 3/4, 3 3 9, 3 4 12, so 3:4. So option number 3 will be the correct answer, 3:4. Next question. Question 4. Total number of person in a company B whose age is 40 and above is what percent of total number of person of in company A whose age is 50 and above. So in company B, 40 and above, 30%. 30% of total number of employee in company B, that is 800. So 30% of 800, which gives 240, divided by what total number of person in company A whose age is 50 and above. Company A whose age is 50 and above is 20%. So total number of employee is 1200. 20% of 1200, that is 240. 240 or iska percentage lena hai, 100%. So ye cut gaya, 100% will be the correct answer. Option number 4 will be the correct answer. Clear to everyone or not? Clear. Next question. Last question. Total number of person in company A whose age is less than 40 is how much more and less, more or less than the total number of person in company B whose age is less than 40. See, in such type of question, just draw a simple one line like this. Okay, these are the 30 and above, this is a 40 and above, and this is 50 and above. Just try to understand first. Okay, now 30 and above are in company A will be 50% student employee. Then 40% employee in company A, that are 40 and above, and in company A 50 and above, that is 20%. Now he is asking about whose age is less than 40. So till this data should be deleted and only this data will be remaining. Okay, so 100% minus this up to here, 40% divided by 100% into total number of employee in company A will be 1200. So this will give you 720. Clear? Now same concept should be applied in other part of this same question. Total number of employee in company B whose age is less than 50. Now see, whose age is less than 50. 30 and above, 40 and above, 50 and above. In company B, talking about company B, so 70%, 30% and 20%. So whose age is less than 50? Less than 50 means this data should be remained as it is. We will delete this much data. So 100% minus 20% divided by 100% into company B, total number of employee will be 800. So multiplied by 800. See this, this, and 80. 80 into 8, it is just 64, 640. So how much difference 720 and 640. Add 60, then 60, 70, 80. So option number 1 will be the correct answer. So if you like this video, do like, comment and share. And also for the quality mock, just visit ibpsguide.com. Thank you for watching and have a nice day.